Sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done marvelous things. His right hand and his holy arm have worked salvation for him. The Lord has made his salvation known and revealed his righteousness to the nations. He has remembered his love and his faithfulness to Israel. All the ends of the earth have seen the salvation of our God. Shout for joy for the Lord, to the Lord, all the earth. Burst into jubilant song with music. Make music to the Lord with the harp and the sound of singing, with trumpets and the blast of the ram's horn. Shout for joy before the Lord, the King. Let the sea resound and everything in it, the world and all who live in it. Let the rivers clap their hands. Let the mountains sing together for joy. Let them sing before the Lord, for he comes to judge this earth. He will judge the world in righteousness and the peoples with equity. The reading of his word.
Anybody have any prayer requests? I don't think any were passed forward. I will remind people and probably share people. Where's Bonnie? Is Joan still in the hospital?
As far as I know, haven't heard from Len, so yeah.
Okay, Joan Pope is in the hospital. She's up at Capitol Health. Claire Hanaway is still in the hospital. She's up at Capitol Health. Bonnie Fort is still in the hospital. She's at Robert Wood. Eleanor?
For our friend and teacher friend, Francine Latin, who, long story, she wound up in the hospital in Croatia after a cruise for 41 days.
Oh, God.
She was sent to the hospital here, finally flew to a hospital, 14 more days, and she's still in rehab.
Wow. Okay, so rehab continued. Anybody else? Gail? He's getting better.
Yes, definitely.
So Bill Wrigley is recovering well after his fall. Mm-hmm. Anybody else? Okay, Richard?
Yeah, just continued with him. He's got problems now.
What?
We've got problems in the basement now, instead. He's doing well.
Okay. Continues for Richard and his care team. Our Heavenly Father, we have so much to be grateful for this day. Lord, for families that have gathered, for friends who are closer than family. Lord, so many good gatherings going on and celebration of Jesus' birth. Lord, we pray that you would be in each and every one of those gatherings, Lord, that you would make the nativity seen so much more real to them this day. This day, oh God, we pray for those in the hospitals, for Joan, for Claire, for Bonnie. Lord, continue with their healing and help them, oh God, be able to come home. We know that many are upset because they can't be home with their families, Lord. But we know that all things are done in your time. So, Lord, we pray for complete healing for them as well. We remember Jeff Shropshire, who had problems with his eye surgery, Lord, that you continue to be with him as the healing continues for him. We pray for Craig as he's in the hospital again in England, Lord, that you would be with his new care team, Lord, and that you would see that his treatment is done correctly and that he has a chance to heal as well. We pray for Richard Liebensberger as he continues with his cancer treatment, Lord. Be with his care team as well, that they would have the compassion and knowledge needed for the times that he goes through. We pray for Francine Latin as she continues in rehab, Lord, and we just thank you that she's finally be able to come home and is in rehab, Lord. And we just pray for her complete recovery as well. We thank you for the healing that's taken place for Bill Wrigley. Lord, continue to speak into his life, Lord. As he deals with his disease, Lord, may he feel your presence in his life as well. And now, O God, we ask you to continue to open our hearts and our minds to your word this day. Fill us with your spirit, Lord, and then use us as you see fit in this world. For we pray all of this in the precious name of Jesus the Christ. Amen. This is going to be one of those days when we will just not all agree with one another. It's a day of celebration, but exactly what celebration looks like to each of us is different. So before we start, let's just agree to disagree, okay?
Sounds good.
Good. For today, we celebrate the birth of Jesus, the one sent from God to save us all. Let's look to the birth account according to the Gospel of Luke, chapter 2. Now this morning I'm going to be reading not from the NIV, but from the New King James. So for those older folks among us, you'll probably recognize this more than you will if we did it in the NIV. Listen now to God's words. And it came to pass in those days that a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be registered. This census took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria. So all went to be registered, everyone to his own city. Joseph also went up from Galilee out of the city of Nazareth into Judea to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be registered with Mary, his betrothed wife, who was with child. So it was that while they were there, the days were completed for her to be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn. Now there were in the same country shepherds living out in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. And behold, an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were greatly afraid. Then the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which will be for all people. For there is born to you this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign to you. You will find a babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, laying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill towards men." So it was, when the angels had gone away from them into heaven, that the shepherds said to one another, "Let us now go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has come to pass, which the Lord has made known to us." And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger. Now when they had seen him, they made widely known the saying which was told them concerning this child. And all those who heard it marveled at those things which were told them by the shepherds. But Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart. Then the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things that they had heard and seen as it was told them. May God continue to awaken our souls as we look to these very familiar words this morning. So what does a celebration mean to you? Is it a lot of people or is it just a few? Is it dressing up and eating exotic food at some fancy restaurant? Is that a celebration? Does it include friends and family, people of all ages? Does it mean escaping the ordinary to a place that you feel is special? Are there gifts to be given and received as well? Can you see how celebration looks different according to the people and according to what the event is? It varies, doesn't it, in how we celebrate it. Now let's talk about that. What things do you do or your family do to celebrate? What do?
Have a party.
Have a party.
Get together.
Get together.
Eat.
We eat food.
Certain foods.
A meal. Open gifts.
FaceTime.
That's a different kind of family, right?
Laugh and be loud.
Is it just for birthdays?
No.
Is it for anniversaries?
Yeah.
Graduations from preschool all the way through grad school, right?
Yeah.
Do you celebrate when your children get good grades in school?
Yes.
Or when they make a goal?
Yeah.
Or when they make a touchdown or get a home run? Speaking of touchdowns, have you celebrated the Eagles? Where's Jane? How about the Phillies? We celebrated even things like that. I think you will all agree that there are occasions that are always celebrated with festivities, even if the festivities are different. There are all kinds of celebrations in Scripture. Not as many as we celebrate today, of course, but let's think of some. Of course, since it's Christmas, I hope you would all say, celebrated the birth of Jesus, right? How did they celebrate the birth of Jesus? Any ideas? How was Jesus celebrated?
They brought gifts, sure.
Excited shepherds.
The angels sang.
Many traveled miles to see a baby, right? Mm-hmm. Now today, I want to point out how Mary celebrated. That verse that seems so opposite than all the others, verse 19 says, "But Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart." Can our celebrations be quiet?
Yeah.
Introspective times, perhaps? Do you think Mary was celebrating the birth in her own way? I do.
Oh, yeah.
So much has happened. It was hard to take everything in, and Mary was filled with much joy, but most likely she was overwhelmed with the entire event. I do believe we can celebrate quietly. We can celebrate these different events by opening our hearts to God with great rejoicing and thanksgiving. To me, that's celebrating. Now, I know that most of you have large family gatherings, and the scene can get pretty intense. Sue said loud. Bonnie already said it was quite loud and chaotic.
Yeah.
But some of us celebrate quietly. But it doesn't mean we're not celebrating. I guess when you grow, for me, growing up, I had a father who hated noise. Well, you learn to do things a bit differently, don't you?
Yeah.
When somebody hates noise in your house. I believe that Mary's heart was about ready to burst. This was such a monumental event, and she was beyond the noise and the chaos. What do you think happened when the shepherds visited them? How would you have felt if a bunch of strange dirty men showed up right after you gave birth? That's a lot different than having friends and relatives show up after giving birth now, isn't it? In Scripture, the prodigal son was celebrated with a huge feast. We know that births were celebrated, especially if it was a male child. I'm sure there was celebrating when the Red Sea parted so that they could go through. There was celebrating every time there was a good day fishing, when a good crop was harvested, and of course, when there was a wedding. What we can learn is that God wants us to celebrate, to take the time to lift our spirits and to be thankful, to recognize each and every blessing which comes in all shapes and sizes, to know in our hearts that all of these things in our lives are possible only because of the wonderful gift that have been given in the form of a baby in a manger. Happy birthday, Jesus. We are so glad you have came. Amen.
Amen.
Wherever you find yourself today, always take time to celebrate. whether it's chaotic and loud or if it's quiet and contemplative, even if you're by yourself, take time to open your heart and your mind to the gift that God has given us. Jesus Christ is born this day. Thanks be to God. Amen.
Amen.